What if your dinner went on a theme park ride inside you? Buckle up, because the moment food crosses your lips, an army of organs, muscles, and microbes begins a carefully choreographed mission. Break it down, steal the good stuff, and get the rest ready for exit. It all starts in the mouth, your front door and first kitchen. Your teeth are grinders and scissors, tearing food into smaller pieces. Saliva, a slick cocktail of water and enzymes, soaks everything and starts the chemical work. Salivary amylase begins nibbling at starches. Chewing turns a bite into a swallowable parcel and sends the job downstream. Once you swallow, control flips from conscious to automatic. The esophagus, a muscular tunnel, performs a smooth wave, peristalsis, that pushes the food toward the stomach like a conveyor belt. At the stomach's mouth, a ring of muscle, the lower esophageal sphincter, relaxes to let the parcel in, and then clamps shut. Welcome to the stomach, the body's built-in blender. Strong muscles churn food into a soupy slurry called chyme. Gastric juices, acid and enzymes like pepsin, start unzipping proteins and killing many microbes. The stomach is brutal but brilliant. Mechanical force, pause chemistry, powerful breakdown. The duodenum, the mixing chamber. When the chyme leaves the stomach, it meets the duodenum, the first stretch of the small intestine, the place where the real magic happens. Here, the pancreas and liver join the party. Pancreas, the enzyme factory. The pancreas pumps out potent enzymes through tiny ducts, amylase for carbs, lipase for fats, proteases for proteins. These enzymes are the specialist tools that cut molecules into pieces small enough to be absorbed. The liver produces bile, a soap-like fluid that emulsifies fat, breaking big fat droplets into tiny droplets so lipase can do its work. The gallbladder stores and squirts that bile into the duodenum on cue. Travel a little further, and the small intestine unfurls a vast wrinkled surface lined with finger-like villi. These villi are the gut's VIP absorbers. Sugars, amino acids, fats, and vitamins slip through them into your bloodstream, or into tiny lymph vessels for some fats. Think of the small intestine as a busy customs center, sorting and shipping nutrients to every cell that needs them. And if you think digestion so far has been wild, wait until you see what happens next, because this is where food is transformed into pure energy for your body. And eventually, well, into something else you'll want to flush away. What's left, mostly water, fiber, and indigestible bits, moves on to the large intestine, colon. This is where water is reclaimed and stool is formed. But the colon is far from boring. Trillions of bacteria live here, fermenting fiber, producing gases, and creating helpful byproducts like certain vitamins and short-chain fatty acids. Those microbes are hard-working roommates. They salvage nutrients and change liquid waste into solid stool. Muscles keep the waste moving with slow, rhythmic squeezes. Water gets absorbed, the mass compacts, and the stool is pushed toward the rectum. Along the way, sensors and nerves assess the contents so your body knows whether it's gas, liquid, or solid. The rectum stores the stool until the timing's right. At the end are two sphincters, one automatic, internal, and one you can control, external. These muscles keep the exit secure and give you time to reach a bathroom. Sensory nerves signal what's inside so you can decide, release, hold, or pass gas. Saliva doesn't just moisten, it contains enzymes that begin digestion immediately. Bile doesn't digest fats, it emulsifies them so enzymes can. Your gut bacteria don't just make gas, they help make vitamins and feed cells in the colon. Peristalsis is the body's quiet, unstoppable mover. Food never needs to fall downward. Muscles do the work. So next time you sit on the toilet, remember, you're witnessing the finale of one of the wildest roller coasters inside your body. If this made you laugh or squirm, hit like, drop a emoji in the comments, and subscribe to Existence Explained, because the next journey might just blow your mind even more.